I was remembering driving through these streets 10 years ago, and there were small trailers, primarily. There were dirt floors where families had a structure of some kind to live in. And many family members packed, literally packed into those living conditions. They had no water and no light in some cases. It was very distressing to visit.
And I saw there, this is real mission territory. This is ripe for the harvest, ripe for the planting, actually, at that time. As a missionary, I like to know that where I'm going, I'm needed. And I knew for certain that I would be needed here in any way that I could help.
The people were very ready to, for something, you know, like they were ready to receive something, and they were just waiting. And I felt that this is the right time to be here and to be present with the people.
And they didn't know who they could trust. And we were trying to show them that the Catholic Church cares about them, and that we are instruments of this church, and that we want to welcome them in and walk this journey with them. And we were asking them, if we build a community center here, what would you like it to do?
There are different needs. The basic needs, the intellectual needs, the psychological needs, and also their spiritual needs. So everything has to be touched according to where they are.
Colonia at that time was kind of a sad place. And I can say honestly now, 10 years later, it's a pretty happy place. It's much larger because of the programs we have here. Our people know one another, they interact with one another. And this center has become a second home for many of them. It's their center. And we tell them that one of these days, we as missionaries are going to move on, but this is going to be yours. And we're showing you how to operate it for their own personal good and for the building of the community.
The title itself, Proyecto Desarrollo Humano, it's human development. And you can't develop the parent and ignore the child or vice versa. And so it's comprehensive. We are all together in this, and we will all benefit from everything that is done.
The hidden tool is faith. The apparent tools on the surface, various programs, ESL classes to learn English, women's leadership classes to give them a sense of the dignity that is theirs, but they may never have even known it, or it's been trampled on so much they're not aware of it anymore. Helping the children do their homework so that the parents and the children can see that there's a chance for them, that just because they're immigrants, Spanish-speaking, poor, that doesn't mean that they cannot develop. And then they sew together, they crochet together. And we also have counseling for them. And those who need medical care get it in our clinics. You put all that together, these are the apparent tools. But underneath it all, faith is the real thing.
We've learned what hope is. We've learned to feel stronger as women, as maybe head of the household, because there's many women that are mother and father here. And you see them struggling, but the center has made it possible for them to see that there's hope and that they can believe.
And so they start to build community among themselves, because that's one of the reasons why we are trying to do this, because we know that the family ties are very strong. And so when they came here, that was cut. You know, they don't mingle with other people because they were afraid. But now they come together, they invite one another in their celebrations, and, you know, come together and talk.
Pope Francis asking us to go to the marginalized is a very good thing, because it affirms our ministry. It affirms what we need to do. It affirms what Jesus is calling us to do.
the community center, and then St. Anne's Church, which we were able to build and pass on to the diocese, kind of completes what an ideal neighborhood could be. You have this place where human needs are met and people's skills are developed, and you have the spiritual home also, which actually grew from having Mass here in our center.
I've heard women expressing that now God is with us, like Emmanuel. So I said, my God, this is awesome, awesome for them to have that feeling.
I see the face of God very strongly in them. They teach me a lot. They're very patient, they're very generous. They teach me that this is living Christianity.
So there is 2,000 families in this colonia. There are many, many people who come new, and so the work goes on. So it doesn't stop. The light of Christ has to reach everybody. It is awesome.
As you have just witnessed, the church is present and vital at the margins, where Catholic Extension lifts up faith leaders like the Sisters of Pueblo de Palmas, Texas.